So, hello everybody, my name is Fulbert Baudouin, and at the previous part, we have taken a look at global diagrams, and in this part, we are going to show you how to design a PID diagram for a control loop, and more specifically, the basic tagging convention from the ISA 5.1 standard. Let's take a look at this figure. It's about a PID diagrams. This figure shows a typical layout for the level control at the base of the column. The control valve should be placed on the discharge line from the pump. Let me show you the operating principle of this control loop. A level transmitter, LT, measures the level in the tank and transmits a signal associated with the level reading to an LIC controller. The controller compares these measurements with the value one wants to maintain the controller variable at, and adjust the manipulated variable which has a direct effect of the controller variable. The manipulated variable is, in this case, the flow rate at the output of the tank. In these PID diagrams, alarms are used to alert operators to serious and potentially hazardous deviations in process conditions. Key instruments are fitted with switches and release or software alarm to operate audible and visual alarm on the control panel and shared display screens. Each control loop is defined by three main devices: a sensor, a controller, and an actuator. In the next slide, we will explain the different symbols and tagging conventions associated with these instruments. The tag number convention is established by the ISA 5.1 standards, which stand for Instrumentation System and Automation Society. This standard establishes a universal means of depicting and identifying instruments or devices and their inherent functions by presenting a designation system that includes identification diagrams and graphic symbols. Furthermore, this standard is intended to provide sufficient information to enable anyone capable of reading flow diagrams and having a reasonable amount of plant knowledge to understand the means of measurements and control of the process. This can be done without having to go into the details of the instrumentation that requires the knowledge of instrumentation specialists. This standard is suitable for use in the chemical, petroleum, power generation, metal refining, as well as pulp and paper industries. As seen previously, these industries and other two require the use of control system and schematic functional diagrams. These schematics help to describe the relationship between processing equipment and the functionality of measurement and control equipment. When you have a look at these PID diagrams, notations may appear difficult. But when examined in details, it can be easily understood and applied when you are creating a new documentation. That is why it is often helpful to consider some examples that illustrate the use of this tagging convention. The letters that make up the first few characters of a typical tag number, the leading letters, are used to identify the function performed by the field device or by the control system. Following this leading letter is a number. The number that appears on the tag is known as the loop number. The loop number is used to uniquely identify one or more field devices that are used to perform a specific function. This combination of function letter and loop number enables a field device in process area to be accurately identified. Knowing the device tag number is required when filling out a work order or in discussing a field measurement with an operator or instrument technician. The tag number assigned to a field device is normally stamped on the tag that is attached to the device. All the devices that are used together to perform a specific function are normally assigned the same loop number. For example, the flow transmitter and regulating valve used to measure and regulate the flow of a process stream may be assigned loop number 101. As defined by ISA 5.1, the identification letters used to specify the function of a field device are organized in the specific manner. The meaning of letter varies depending on whether it is a first letter or a subsequent letter. A table of the identification letter defined by the standard is shown in this slide. This table is divided into several columns and you can see two main columns named first letters and succeeding letters. The column named first letters is used to designate the measure variable like P for pressure, T for temperature, L for level. In some cases, you need both letters to define a measured variable. For example, the letter D will never be used as a first character, but it is associated to the first letter to indicate differential. For example, PD means differential pressure. This is generally used to measure the difference of pressure between the top and the bottom of the distillation column. Another example is the letter Q for integrations. This letter is associated to the first one to indicate an integration of the measurement over time. For example, FQ means a water meter. The second main column, called subsequent letter, is used to designate the function of the component or to modify the meaning of the first letter. For example, TV means a valve that controls the measured variables, here the temperature. Now, we are going to present some examples to better understand the tagging conventions for control loops. Firstly, we are going to explain the tagging convention for the sensors. The primary sensors encountered in the chemical industry are pressure with P, temperature with T, flow rate with F, and level with L. Those first letters can be associated with other letters, like E for example. In this case, it means the sensor alone, the primary element. The output of the primary element is referred to as raw signal, and the type of raw signal depends on the kind of sensor. A classic example is the PT100 sensor for measuring the temperature. The primary element is a sensor alone, just the PT100, and the output of this sensor is a resistance function of the temperature. The symbol associated with this sensor is TE, T for temperature, and E for primary element. If you want to indicate that the sensor is a sensor transmitter, you have to put the letter T after the first letter, in second or third position. As remember, a transmitter is a device that converts a reading from a sensor or transducer into a standard signal, in general, a 4 to 20 mA current loop. In a control loop, an elementary sensor must be connected to a transmitter. Sometimes, operators need to check a measurement directly in the process. An indicator makes the reading possible. An indicator is a device readable by humans that displays information about the process. Indicators may be as simple as a pressure gauge or more complex, such as digital readout device. The symbol associated with an indicator is the letter I. For example, PI means a pressure indicator but not connected to a controller. FIT means a temperature indicator with a transmitter. This kind of sensor could be connected to a controller. When the second or the third letter is C, the associated device is a controller. A controller is a device that receives data from a measurement instrument, compares that data to a program set point, and sends a corrective signal to an actuator. Local controllers are usually one of the three types: pneumatic, electronic, or programmable. Controllers may perform complex mathematical functions to compare measurements to set points, or they may perform simple subtraction functions to make comparisons. Common examples of controllers include PLC, for Programmable Logic Controller, is a computer connected to a set of input-output devices. The computer a program to respond to input by seeding output to maintain all processes at a set point. DCS, for distributed control system, combines one or more PLC with a human-machine interface. It is a controller that, in addition to performing control function, provides readings of the status of the process, maintains databases, etc. More explanation about this controller will be given at the part 3. Sometimes, controllers have a recorder to save data. In order to inform technician or engineer about this feature, the letter R is put in the second or third position. A recorder is a device that records the output of measurement devices. Many process manufacturers are required by law to provide a process history to regulatory agencies. Manufacturers use recorders to help meet these regulatory requirements. In addition, they often use recorders to collect data for strain analysis. By recording the readings of critical measurement points and comparing those readings over time with the result of the process can be improved. Some examples are given in these slides. LIC means a controller to control the level. In this controller, an indicator is to build weight. TRC means a controller to control temperature. And with this controller, it is possible to record some data. Temperature over time, for example. PC is just the controller to control the pressure. When the second or third letter is a V, the associated device is a valve. A valve is an actuator, which means a part of a final control device that causes a physical change. For example, LV or LCV for control valves means a valve to adjust the flow rate in order to control the level. As a reminder, the first letter, in this case L, is used to designate the measured variable or controlled variable. PV means a valve to adjust the flow rate in order to control the pressure. Further explanation will be given in part 4 about the different kinds of valves and their technology. In order to warn operators of potential problems, alarms are placed in the control room. This could be height measure alarms and or low measure alarms. The tagging identification letters for alarm is very easy to understand. Take a look at this example. The first letter is a measure variable. Here, the temperature. The letter A placed in the second position indicates that the symbol is associated with an alarm. So, this alarm is applied to the temperature. If you want to warn operators that the temperature is higher than a defined threshold, you have to use the letter H at the end of the tagging conventions. On the other hand, you have to use the letter L if you want to warn operators that the temperature is below a defined threshold. So, in this part, we have explained the basic tagging convention from the ISA 5.1 standard in order to specify the function of a field device. Identification letter on the ISA standard indicate first the variable being measured, for example, flow, level, temperature, pressure, etc. The device functions like transmitter, valve, controller, or some modifiers, high, low, etc. The example shown at the beginning of this part can be analyzed in more details. The first letter for all devices is L, so this control loop refers to the level. That is why a level sensor is connected to the tank. A transmitter is associated to this one and converts the raw signal at the output of the sensor to a normalized electrical signal, 4 to 20 mA current loop. This standard signal is sent to a controller. Two alarms warn the operator if the level is too high, LAH, or too low, LAL. A controller with an indicator induces an output signal function of measurement and the set point. This control signal is sent to the valve in order to adjust the flow rate and maintain a constant level equal to the desired value. So, in the next parts, we will focus on shape symbols and lines for equipment connection.